Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Luke Mitchell Show. Welcome back. Episode 3. I want to first start by saying, please, for the love of God, like, comment, and subscribe. I want to make more than $50,000 a year one year or in the future. So the only way that's going to ever happen is if I grow a fucking following. So just subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and for the love of Christ, comment. And the first thing I'm going to ask you to comment on is what song is better? Okay, here we go. I'm gonna start this one off. I'm not gonna say anything biased, but here we go. Here's the first one.
Dr. Fauci, give us vaccines. Help all the people who have been quarantined. We'll wear our masks and we'll have to stay distant. We'll wash our hands and we'll be more resistant. Fauci, yes? Promise us, please. We'll have a cure that can fight off this disease. Restrictions will lift with some ease. Dr. Fauci, don't forget me.
All right. First one. I don't know. Does it sound cool to you? It sounds cool to fucking me. All right, number two. This is for all you real motherfuckers out there. Well, I won't back down. No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. From what? No, I stand my ground. Oh, fuck yeah, I get it. Won't be turned around. You don't like this song? Eat my ass. From dragging me down. I'm gonna stand my ground. And I won't back down. I won't back. Hey, baby. There ain't no easy way out. Hey, yeah. We'll stand my ground. Back down. Well, I know what's right. I got just one life. In a world that keeps on pushing me around, but I'll stand my ground. I'm gonna stand my fucking ground. And I won't back down. Hey, baby. Woo! I'm gonna let it play all the way through. Fuck you. This is my show. I let the fucking Rugrat go all the way through. I'm gonna let Tom Petty go. And I won't back down. Oh my God. If you don't like that one, you need to get your fucking head checked. Hold on, let me adjust my mic here. Fuck yeah, freedom, baby. Motherfucking freedom. Did we ever see freedom this weekend when we saw a full stadium full of just cheering fans, people wearing masks, people not wearing masks, whatever you wanted to do. Freedom. Huh, weird. Not some fucking insane people trying to control every fucking thing you do. Woo! I came in hot. My nipples are hard. As good as that Dr. Fauci gimmick was, I think Tom Petty was onto something there, and it ain't about backing down. We need to open up. I'm gonna start playing Tom Petty in this fucking off my balcony nonstop. Okay, every fucking day. Woo! Remember when people used to like the thought of not backing down, and now they all just walk around like worker ants. That just don't know, don't even, they just like, worker ants just literally move around and provide for some queen I've met once. People haven't even met these politicians and they run around for them like little slave girls. I mean, right now, you go on Facebook anywhere, we got the jab hucksters out there. These fucking pussies are posting statistical shit as if they work.
for AstraZeneca. They're posting facts. They may as well come to my door, knock on my door, and be one of those guys who preaches their fucking religion at my front door. And then if I give them the light of day, they keep going and going, and they want like coffee and tea and biscuits to come in and preach their shit. What is happening? Who are these losers? I know some that spend their day. They're not good. Here's the thing. They're not good at anything at all. So they just spend their time posting articles they find, and they don't even really read it. They just read the headline. They just post it on shit. And it's hilarious. I mean, we have hucksters who don't even work for the companies anymore trying to sling shit. You know what I say? You know whose video you would like? The little Dr. Fauci boy. Not that it, like, I don't care. Get it, whatever. I think people, if they want to get it, they should. But I'm fucking more angry at the hucksters who act like they give a fuck about you. These people couldn't give a fuck if your mom got, I don't know, eaten by a fucking shark in Florida, let alone gotten any sort of, any. Do you think these people were out posting shit about the fucking flu jab ever? Do you know any people die from just the flu? Were they posting blood clot articles on comparing it to fucking birth control? And who, oh my God, is birth control mandatory to take? No. So what do you, people are so boring. Oh my God. Get good at something. Stop fucking feeding into social media and trying to virtue signal all the fucking time. Get good at something. If you literally got into your dad's business or your mom's business or just never, there's nothing wrong with that, but it's like you like have never been creative. And there's nothing wrong with not wanting to be creative. But I'm saying, don't waste my fucking time with your bullshit posts. I don't even know if my other comparisons made sense. Who gives a fuck? I'm spending the time to make something. At least I can. I have a platform to bitch about stuff. And we played some Tom Petty, baby. But if you're out here slinging Johnson & Johnson, you should just fucking go to Vietnam and lay down on bamboo and just let it grow through your body. That's what I think. Like, if you're out here hucking Pfizer and trying to be like one of these people who just like has a jacket full of bullshit drugs, and I just walk up to you on the side of the street, that's kind of like what I'm doing on Facebook. I'm like opening my feed and I happen to stumble across your post. And your jacket's open like this, and you're like, what do you want? The JJ, the AstraZeneca, Pfizer, you got them all. And it's just like, you should go and you should go into the Nile River and paint yourself with pig's blood and see what happens. That's what I think. If you're trying to sling this shit, you should get gangbanged by 50 huge guys and girls. I don't care. They're pulling you apart. They're having fun with you. Just stop with the slinging. For the love of God. If people want it, they're going to fucking get it. Enough about that. I also promised I would fucking have someone who's way smarter than me read this Stanford piece about masks. This podcast is going to be very short-lived. I actually hadn't read it, so I actually am genuinely interested to see what this heavily cited my medical hypothesis had to offer. So I'm going to read some of the Cole's notes here. Okay. Efficacy of face masks. So I'm going to show you. There's basically highlighted parts I've been told that are the most important. So I'll just read through and see. Leave a comment. See what you think. See what if your opinion matters when it comes to science. Because apparently it does now. Apparently everyone's fucking opinion matters now. This is... If I have a false opinion, I'm so cool with admitting it. But everyone who's just like, loves their fucking opinion so much, they just can't imagine their opinion being wrong. And here's the thing. It doesn't matter if my opinion or your fucking opinion's wrong. There's science. Hello, you fucking retards. Okay, here we go. The physical properties of medical and non-medical face masks suggest that face masks are ineffective to block viral particles due to their differences in scale. He cites three things. According to the current knowledge, the virus SARS-CoV-2 has a diameter of 60 nm to 140 nanometers, billionth of a meter. While medical and non-medical face masks thread diameter ranges from 50 to 440 micrometers, 1 millionth of a meter, which is more than 1,000 times larger. Due to the difference in sizes between SARS-CoV-2 diameter and face mask thread diameter, the virus is 1,000 times smaller. SARS-CoV-2 can easily pass through any face mask. But my opinion is, if everyone in a shopping mall has a face mask on, then no, it's going to be much harder. It's like, dude, we're throwing a bowling ball between two goddamn mountains here. And whatever, if you want to wear it, fucking wear it. But enough with the mask outside bullshit. If you have a mask on outside, help me God. I mean, anyways, I'm not going to continue on that. My whole thing is, stop slinging shit. Stop slinging shit. There's way fucking smarter people than you and I. And don't go on your Facebook trying to fucking virtue signal. I am so fucking sick of virtue signaling bullshit on Facebook and Instagram. And everyone's like, well, then don't go on. It's like, well, dude, do you know any things I want to see on there? Like animals dancing? There's a lot of really cool things on there. Just because I'm allowed, and that's the best part. We're in a free country, right? So I can go on, I can bitch about seeing this stuff, but that's the good beauty of a free country. I can bitch about it. You can bitch about me, I bitch about you. Let's have some fucking coffee and go on a patio and bitch. Doesn't everyone just bitch? I think literally 30% of life is just bitching. Like, I just wake up and I go, fuck, I slept terrible. Half my wake up, sir, I fucking slept terrible, and now this day is shot. I'm not a guy who leaves Yelp reviews, but I might start now. It seems like that's a fucking good comparison. I wish there was a Yelp review for how everything's being handled right now. Just specifically for this whole pandemic. Like, my Yelp review for Florida would be 5 out of 5. Great service. Everyone was enjoying their life. Everyone seems healthy. They're getting vitamin D. My Yelp review for Ontario, they fucked the pooch. They just yelled at me the whole time. Nobody's friendly. Maybe some people are, but you try to be friendly and they look at you like you have fucking 14 heads. And they walk, like, you're on a sidewalk and they walk across to the other sidewalk like you're the dirty one. Even though they look like they sleep outside for fun and they have to. That's where we're at. That's my Yelp review of this place. And I can do Yelp review because I've been to both. And I see how people are taking this situation in Ontario compared to how they're taking it in Florida. And they're enjoying their fucking lives. And I heard this puke, dude, there are people everywhere talking about how bad we have it here right now. Every fucking where. There are so many cucks who are loving this shit. Like, Andrew Schultz is a comedian in Florida right now. And he even said on his podcast, this guy is pretty level-headed. He said, at what point is it not about the science? At what fucking point? Nobody here is willing to give the idea that maybe we're not doing... I mean, they're going to say we're not doing... But all the reasons they're saying we're not doing it right are just fucking so dumb. Like, if only you wore your mask, if only they shut flights off immediately, it's like, Shut the fuck up. All right, I'm not going to bitch about this anymore. Who gives a fuck what I think about this? I have a couple notes here on my phone. I'm gonna go over. Oh yeah, also, don't forget the comment. Who had the better song? I know where my comment's leaning. All right, so my fuck, I can't go straight into more illness. Okay. The UFC happened this weekend. I mean, fuck, that was so incredible just to see a full crowd, everyone cheering. Dana White said it, but I mean, a lot of people don't like Dana, but he said, if you wanted to wear a mask, you would wear a mask. If you didn't, you didn't have to. We've already proven that the virus is smaller than masks, so if you want to wear it, whatever. But it was amazing to see that many people at an event and just like enjoying life again. It gave me a little bit of like, oh fuck, okay, because I've been pretty down about this whole thing and how we're handling it. It gave me a little kick in the nuts. It fired me right up. Get back writing my book. I'm writing a book, by the way. It got me excited to make a sketch. I shot my sketch, by the way. I'm editing it right now. I met Ben Bankus, fucking hilarious comedian. He is like what you see on camera. That's him in person. He has a microphone set up facing. He has a huge mic thing pushed right against his window, and randomly throughout the day he'll open his window and turn his microphone on and just yell at people on the streets. He's great. He's like a cartoon character, but a good guy. Really funny. But the UFC, sorry, I fucking went way off. The UFC this weekend, I liked it. At the same time, I didn't. It just, everything, there were like so many fights that just ended so early. And the one guy I wanted to win lost. So for example, Anthony Smith versus Jimmy Crute. First fight of the main card. Jimmy Crute blows his knee out in the first round and is wobbling like his knee is made of fucking aloe plant. It's just like he can't even step properly. So that fight goes no more than one round. Chris Weidman versus Uriah Hall. For all those of you who don't know, Chris Weidman fought the great Anderson Silva, I want to say 4 or 5 years ago. And I think they were in the second round, and Chris Weidman did a thing where he lifted his leg up because Anderson Silva had deadly kicks, right? So, oh my God, is my thing. Oh, for fuck's sakes. There we go. Okay. So Anderson Silva has deadly kicks. And there's a thing you can do called checking a kick. So Chris Weidman, basically, it's like where you're standing in your fighter stance, and whatever leg is coming, you tilt your shin and knee towards that leg, right? If he's doing a low kick. So what happened was Anderson Silva caught his shin square on Weidman's knee. And it broke both bones and it snapped his leg clean in half. And that's what happened to... So that he ended basically... Anderson Silva was like on a streak, the best ever. And it completely killed that. Like Anderson Silva was never the same. Fast forward to now... Chris Weidman, the first strike thrown in the fight, throws that same kick Anderson Silva threw, and he broke his shin in half. The exact same way Anderson Silva did. That's only happened 3 times in the UFC, and 2 of them, it was like this, like it happened to 2 guys that were involved in similar incidents. It's pretty crazy. It's like, all I could think was like, holy shit, karma's real. Karma's real. Craziness. So yeah, that ended in like 9 seconds. Okay. Then Valentina Shevchenko versus Jessica Andrade. This fight was fun to watch because it just showed how good Valentina is. Like, there's no one that's going to beat her within her weight class. She has 3 losses, and 2 of them are to a chick that's 10 pounds heavier than her. Right? So she just dummied Andrade. And it ended, like, I think, a minute into the second round. She literally held both her arms behind her head and fucking beat her to a pulp. Then Rose, so that's another fight. So that's three fights barely making it 6 minutes in, right? So then Rose, Nami Yunus versus Wale Zhang. I don't know how to say her name, but they fight. I had Wale winning, but she got her fucking head kicked off. I want to say in the first round. I'm not confident, but if it was not the first, it was like a minute into the second. So that's four fights now that barely made it 6 minutes. Now the last fight, the one I was most excited for, Kamaru Usman versus Masvidal, Journeyman George. He looked like a journeyman after this one, and it's like, you can talk shit. He's like done insane things. I'm just saying that as a joke. George looks so fucking good in that first round. Like, so, I was like, holy shit, he's gonna win. I was like excited. I wanted him to win so bad. He looked like, and I don't know how much of my audience here watched UFC, but I love this shit. So he looked like what Tony Ferguson would have looked like had he fought Khabib in his prime. Like, Kamaru is known for taking people down. He's a wrestler, right? Masvidal was on his back slicing this guy, beating the shit out of him, winning the round dominantly, and even able to get back up. Like, Kamaru didn't want to hold the guy down. He was getting sliced so bad. Fucking in the second round, they're striking, which is Masvidal's strong suit. Like, he's like one of the better strikers in the UFC. And he just fucking starts giggling like an insane person and then gets his lights put out. It's so fucking frustrating to watch. I'm like, why are you doing this? This guy doesn't lose. Why are you fucking giggling around with him like he's your best friend and you're on the monkey bars together? Kill him, for fuck's sakes. My heart sank, and then my heart was already sunk, and then I had to fucking watch the Tim Dillon show, which I was super excited for, because he had, Jordan Peterson on, and I'm thinking, oh man, here we go, Tim's gonna, like, get crazy, talk some shit. They talked about, like, mental health and Peterson's battle with opioid addiction for the whole episode. So I'm coming off the low of Masvidal getting his fucking lights put out. And then I have to listen to Jordan Peterson talk about almost dying for a year. So maybe I was too drunk, but it felt like that's all they talked about. And I'm a huge Tim Dillon show fucking fan, and that ruined. And then I had to watch, to top it off, I had, I guess from fucking like 12 at night till 4 a.m. when I was just boozing alone and eating edamames, I had the worst night ever, because then I watched that fucking, my buddy Mike told me to watch the Eric Andre movie, where they do, like, the real life, gags, I don't know, like, the pranks, and I don't know why, I just could, maybe I was too wasted, but I was like, this is rough to watch. It was rough. They kept cutting to Tiffany Haddish, and, like, I don't want to talk shit, but I don't know. I didn't like the movie, but I just seemed like her character, they just kept doing the same thing. It was just like, have you seen these two guys? Have you seen these two? Ha! And it was like, every time it would cut to, like, eight different locations, her just asking people if she... The only funny thing they did with her was she, like, stole a cop car, and people were like, praise Jesus. And then Eric Andre got fucked by a gorilla, like a fake gorilla, at a zoo, and all these, like, black people are like, oh, praise Jesus, he's gonna need... I guess this was a funny part. Eric Andre went back into the cage after getting fucked once because he left his cell phone and got fucked again in front of all these people. And I imagine just, like, being at a zoo and just watching some guy go back into a gorilla cage after getting fucked already by the gorillas. Pretty funny. But if you think about a gorilla, like, if he fucked you, it would rip you in half. Physically, because apparently they have small dicks. I woke up in the morning, and I guess I had YouTube what gorillas look like while they're actually banging. So I was looking at my phone, I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, when I'm drunk, I just don't even make sense. It's weird. But yeah, they just look like, the weirdest part to me about gorillas fucking was, like, their friends come by and, like, pat them on the shoulder while it's happening. I found that odd. That's the only thing I really remember from watching that. But what are you going to do? They're in the jungle. What are we going to do? Here, listen, gorillas, don't pat your friends on the shoulder while they bang unless you're shooting a porno. So, today is a big day, ladies and gentlemen. Today, Tesla reports earnings. I'm excited. I think they're going to blow. They already blew. So, I've been investing in Tesla, right? I like stocks. Fuck it. I like stocks. I like kind of like throwing my money in and knowing it's going to just go up for a while. And just continually buying in. That's how you free yourself. You fucking just learn the game, invest, and one day you'll have a shitload of money. And maybe you'll hit a home run. You'll get a Tesla or like an Apple. Anyways, Tesla's earnings today, which basically means through all of quarter one, they piece it together and say, okay, we sold X amount of cars, we had X amount of profit, we had total revenue, everything. It's just they tell you everything, and sometimes if you have a great earnings, the stock can go up 10%, right? So, or if you have a really shit one, it can go down 10%. But long-term, earnings don't mean much. All that really matters is that you hold. Hold the company and do not sell. If you believe in it. If you don't, I don't know what the hell you're buying it for. You've lost your mind. Like if you, the amount of people who just ask me about companies they don't like. So I got my dad into this, and for some reason he thinks he knows how to swing trade now because he watches YouTubers, and I'm sure he does. I don't mean the shit on my dad, but usually if you get into swing trading, you've been in the market for at least 5 years. Like he's been in for 8 months. And I got my parents into Tesla, and it was a fucking home run. I went through 2 years of horrific shit trying to figure out how this all works before I even got like my feet in the ground and get confident with this. And now because they've made so much off Tesla, he's now cocky enough to just start swing trading. So, and he watches like these YouTubers who look like they live in caves, and they just like have like 14 shitty HP 1991 Microsoft computers running, and it's like green lit. Their eyes are sunken in, and they look thirsty. They look like they don't get vitamins, and they just watch charts go all day. And they're like, oh, this 38 cent one hit three charter bang stock. This thing is gonna be huge. I don't know how to tell you. This thing is gonna be fucking huge. If it hits, listen, when it hits the 49 cent mark, bang, we sell. If it goes to the 27, we load back up. It's just like these people just sit in their houses and watch. I'm not saying you can't make money swing trading. I'm just saying what kind of life is that? You know? It's just they don't look well. It's addictive. My dad, at least, he just like sits there on the couch and doesn't give a fuck. And it's swing trading and day trading, so. But anyways, back to Tesla. These fucking guys, this is going to be at least a $4 trillion company. They're going to have a $4 trillion market cap by 2030. Put your fucking money in Tesla. I'm telling you. Get in there. They have the. Have you seen the video of the Vegas loop? Look at this shit. They basically have like a subway system in all around Vegas happening. And it's just like all Teslas. And they do it for everything for cheaper. This guy, you know when you like are so, you have so many things going on that are like world changing? Like most people don't have a book they're reading. This guy has he's running Tesla, SpaceX. He's trying to get people on fucking Mars. He's trying to put solar panels on roofs and shit. Like most people don't even read for 30 minutes a day. This guy is doing so much shit I can't even keep up with. I just found out they sent fucking 4 people into orbit on the 23rd. And he's like releasing it's like this guy, I just can't imagine how little sleep he gets. Apparently he sleeps well. Anyways, I'll show you this loop. Tesla Vegas loop. This shit's crazy. I wonder which one I should play. I'll just play this one.
Well, as you descend the escalator into the Loop station, you see the Teslas waiting to whisk you into a tunnel 43 feet below ground. Now, you might think, all right, it's like a subway. But this is more like a highway underground. And because it's Las Vegas, this is also a thrill ride.
Oh, she's having fun.
The Las Vegas Convention Center Loop is
she might be having too much fun.
Thrill ride, part light and sound show, but mostly just a commute across a sprawling convention center.
If there's a show going on and you've got a lot of traffic in the convention center, it can be a 45-minute walk from one end to the other.
The Loop gets you there in less than 2 minutes. Here's how it works. You enter the station and call for a Tesla.
The system operates like an Uber or a Lyft, where you have an app on your phone. You say, I'm here. I want to go there. Car comes up, has an identifier on it that matches with what is on the app on your phone.
Passengers don't have to make multiple stops because there are multiple exits. You go directly to your station of choice. The convention center has three, but plans are in the works to build a loop system citywide.
I'm looking right now. I mean, there's the Ferris wheel. There's the new sphere under construction. The stadium is out there somewhere waiting to be used. Are you saying that eventually this loop is going to connect people from the airport to downtown to the stadium and everywhere in between?
It will, and that eventually is not that far away.
Construction on this loop was completed in 2 years for a cost of less than $53 million, including the stations. It's designed to handle 4,400 people an hour with 62 cars, right now with drivers, but soon they'll be autonomous. And
I mean, could you think of a better place to have the first one than Vegas? You make it, it's actually brilliant. You make it like showy, showcasey. It's like always, that's how Elon Musk started with Tesla. He made a luxury electric car first, so all the celebs had it. Same thing with this burrowing company, right? You put it in the most showy spot. He tried to do LA, which makes sense too. But it didn't end up, like, he didn't get going with it. And I guess Vegas, I it's so fucking smart. The way I like to approach it from this angle, like, get it looking showy, lights flashing everywhere. Yeah, like, the only thing I was thinking about was how many people are going to, like, fucking blow each other in these Teslas when they're autonomous. There's just going to be, like, people get so fucking tuned in Vegas, there's just gonna be people yakking all over the back interior. Like, I know Ubers already have a nightmare, but it's like, if this car's driving itself and someone just shits on the seat, what then? Like, if someone has like three people having group orgy in the back of a Model 3, and there's just like video footage, and people at Tesla are like, oh, surveilling, and they're just like, oh, well, there's a guy getting a Hummer with a guy eating his ass out and a girl jerking both of them off at the same time. What do you do? Do you just say, like, what, does the car drive back and get cleaned up by some mop boy? Or do the people at Tesla just sit there and watch and slow jerk and then not tell anyone, and then the next person gets in the car? It's just like there's cum and shit everywhere. I don't know. Maybe I should work for Tesla and bring up these important problems. Because if I got into a Tesla and I stepped into a puddle of piss and cum, I might be a little bit distraught. It might affect my ability to ever get in a Tesla again. Maybe people are different, though. I'm finding people are a little different than me lately. A lot lately, actually. Anyways, guys, I'm going to end it on that. Go Tesla. Don't post on Facebook anymore about your opinions, because people would rather kill themselves, including me. Oh, I forgot to fucking cover this. Okay, for next episode, Leprosy Island. We'll dig in. It's hilarious. All right, bye.